of the pyruvate, and essentially it's going to be released as carbon dioxide. So this is our carbon dioxide being released here, and then the rest of our pyruvate, which is essentially an acetyl group, that latches on to coenzyme A. And you'll hear a lot about coenzyme A. Sometimes they'll write just, you know, CoA like this. Sometimes it'll be CoA, and then the sulfur connected bonded to the hydrogen. And the reason why they'll draw the sulfur part is because the sulfur is what bonds with the acetyl group right over here. So when, so you have the carbon dioxide being
cellular respiration.
The acetyl group bonding with that sulfur, and by doing that, you form acetyl CoA. And acetyl CoA, just so you know, you only see three letters here, but this is actually a fairly involved molecule. This is actually a picture of acetyl CoA. I know it's really small, but I do appreciate that it's a more involved molecule. That the acetyl group that we're talking about is just this part right over here. And it's a coenzyme. It's really acting to transfer that acetyl group. We'll see that in a second. But it's also fun to look at these molecules, because once again, we see these patterns over and over again in biology or biochemistry. Acetyl CoA, you have an adenine right over here. It's hard to see, but you have a ribose, and you also have two phosphate groups. So this end of the acetyl CoA is